Dr. Shriram Joshi with us, author and psychiatrist, and he's going to talk about trading psychology, how traders can overcome deficiencies of their own mindsets and achieve better results. So, sir is ready. Let's give him a huge round of applause. Now all the psychology will come out with the movie names specially. After that, all the psychology he will teach you.
So, good afternoon, everyone. I am happy to be here today for the simple reason that Mr. Kedia has called me here to do something which I enjoy very much, that is talking. As a psychiatrist, in my clinic, I always have to listen. And at my home, I don't get a chance to speak. So I always look for all such opportunities. So thank you, Mr. Kedia, for calling me here. Yeah, I am Dr. Shriram Joshi, CMT. So this slide depicts my career graph till now. And currently I am pursuing both my careers. Many a times when people come to know that I am a psychiatrist, they feel as if I decided to chuck medicine and get into technical analysis, but that's not so. Medicine is my first love and technical analysis is the second one. Yeah. My life was like this 10-12 years ago. Pretty enjoyable. Morning, evening, I would go to my clinic, afternoon, relax, pursue all my hobbies. I have lots of hobbies, draw portraits, play keyboard, play chess, read. And it is during the hobby of reading that I came across a book on technical analysis. And till that time, I used to feel that stock market is gambling. And my childhood friend, he's a broker, he's my neighbor, he could not tempt me into the stock market. My life was like this. And once I was introduced to the stock market, obviously my life is not like this now. Okay. I have many hobbies. I have pursued all my hobbies passionately, without thinking of the rewards. The intrinsic rewards were enough for me. So same way I pursued the hobby of technical analysis also. But God had other plans and this hobby turned into a serious profession. I met my friend Mr. Hemant Kale and both of us, we have written these two books. The first, Time Your Trades with technical analysis, was written by three of us, one Mr. Pradhan and both of us, and the second one, The Magic and Logic of Elliott Waves, was written by Hemant and me. So my life changed from being only a psychiatrist to I became a technical analyst, I became an author, and now I am also a trainer. I have always enjoyed teaching and taught a lot of subjects. So I teach for CMT exams, I train for technical analysis, I train for Elliott Waves. Now generally, if you look at evolution, progress happens in life. But in our life, the reverse happens. If you look back into your life, you will realize, and if you honestly answer questions, are you better placed compared to 10 years ago? In some aspects, you will be better placed, but in some aspects, we are deteriorating. So, and why the deterioration happens is because of this. Progress happens by conscious choice. It cannot happen by default, whereas deterioration happens by default. Let me give you a small example. If there is a motorbike and I apne ko wo bigadna hai, what needs to be done? Nothing. Just keep it like that, it will get deteriorated. But if you have to keep it in good condition, you have to do a lot of hard work. Regularly, consistently. If you want to become a bad trader, you don't have to do anything. But if you have to become a good trader, you have to do lots of things regularly, consistently. And people don't understand this. The problem why people lose in the stock market, first of all, is the feeling that if I am successful in one profession, I would be successful in another profession also. So many a times we are successful in one profession and then we have the money and we want to enter the stock market, and the stock market seems extremely easy. I always say the least amount of effort is needed to make money in the stock market. The effort needed to utter just two words, you have to utter once buy, once sell. How much effort is needed? Not much. But it's not so simple. These words have to be uttered at the right time. And in between, there has to be a pause. And in between, you should have the ability to sit quietly without saying buy or sell. And that is what is difficult. I'll give you some examples why people fail in the stock market. People fail in the stock market because they are taking the real life mindset to the stock market. In real life, if my finger gets trapped, what will I do? I'll try to save it. I'll call my friends, police, fire brigade, try to save the finger. In the stock market, if my finger gets trapped, and if I give a real life response of trying to save my finger, my hand gets trapped and my whole arm goes in. So in the stock market, I need to sit with a knife, and the minute my finger gets trapped and I come to know finger is trapped, take the knife, cut it. We don't do that in real life. So this response has to be learned. In real life, when finger gets trapped, we don't cut it because fingers don't grow back. In the stock market, you have to understand, as a trader, fingers do grow back. And the best response is to be alert, and the minute you realize your finger is trapped, cut it. Now this cut it response has to be learned. It cannot, we have not learned it from our birth, or, you know, it's a new response for us. Second thing, in the real life, I need to be loyal to my wife. So loyalty is good. In the stock market, if you are loyal to your share, you have had it. In the stock market, you need to be a very promiscuous person. Isko pakda kaam ho gaya, chhod diya. Usko pakda kaam ho gaya, chhod diya. The problem with people is whatever they ought to do in real life, they do it in the stock market. And whatever they ought to do in stock market, they do it in real life. So the rules of the stock market, the environment of the stock market is totally different, and unless you get accustomed, adapted to it, prepared for it, you won't be successful. I'll give you a third example. In real life, we have made our life very much predictable. If, for example, I am at Andheri station and I go to the platform, we just need to see the indicator. Indicator says church gate. We don't need to ask anyone. We just sit in the train. We sleep in the train. It reaches church gate. So we are in real life accustomed to a predictable environment, one on which you can rely on. The stock market environment is not a predictable environment. It is a very unpredictable environment. If in the stock market scenario, if you go to Andheri station, the indicator may say church gate, you are a fool if you believe it. Because it will go anywhere. So how do you counter that? You will go, sit, ask people around. Bhaiya, train kidhar jata hai? Everyone will say church gate. And another of our quality is that dusra bhi khadde mein girta hoga na, to apne ko khadde mein girne ka dar nahi rehta. And then we feel comfortable. So people around say, ye train church gate ja rahi hai. Still you can't believe it. If you know, when the R power issue was listed, everyone said church gate. But the train went to Virar. So how do you deal with an environment like that, which is so unpredictable, which is not our regular real life environment? How do you deal with that? By breaking the rules, by creating new rules, by gearing up for that environment. In the real life, I am a very safe, conservative person. As a doctor, we are taught, first, do no harm. You may not be able to help the patient, but first, do no harm. So we are all conservative people. I always tell everyone, bhaiya, chalte gaadi mein mat chadna. But in the stock market, the rules are different. You can't believe the indicator. You can't believe what people around are saying. The only way to deal with that market is stand in front of the train. Once the train starts, jump in. In real life, chalte train mein kabhi nahi chadna hai. Stock market mein chalte train mein hi chadna hai. Now, too many people, like I've been hearing, not here, everywhere, I keep reading, hearing, all traders, investors are obsessed with trying to find the bottom and the top, trying to find the turning points. The question is, do you want to make profits or you want to predict the markets? My aim is crystal clear. I am in the stock market for making profits. And I will use whatever works. So if I want to make profits in the market, I have to figure out what works for me and what is safe. What works for me is extremely important. I keep hearing someone says, I don't believe in Elliott. Don't believe. The Elliotticians, I am sure, for them it's not a religion to profess and cultivate and all that. I don't believe in technicals. Don't believe. I don't believe in fundamentals. Don't believe. Put your energy into finding a system which works for you. Don't put your energy into trying to prove that something is not working. You know, if you want to make profits, you have to figure out what works for you. Whatever works for me may not work for you. It's like this. I stay at Ghatkopar, I came here. There are different ways of coming here. What is important? Reaching here. Which way I came is not important. Ultimately, I have to reach here. I may come by train, I may come by cab, I may come walking, whatever. So you want to... So this thing has to be crystal clear. Many traders get into philosophical arguments and debates. दे शुड बी क्रिस्टल क्लियर. अपने को मार्केट में रहना है तो पैसा कमाने के लिए. एंड वॉट एवर इज वर्किंग फॉर मी, हाउ डू यू फिगर आउट? ट्राई इट. यू वोंट बी एबल टू फिगर आउट विदाउट ट्राइंग इट. ओके, सो दिस फर्स्ट थिंग, 1 hour दे हैव गिवन मी, 45 minutes I am supposed to talk and then get take questions. This topic is not, I can't do justice for that in 45 minutes, but my attempt will be what? I'll tell you. Now I'll speak in computer language. When we download a program, for it to work, it has to be installed. It has to be run. All of us sitting here, including me, I'm not excluding me, all of us sitting here have lots of knowledge, have lots of new information useful into our brain. Are we using it? No. I'm sure there will be some smokers here. We have the information smoking is bad. Are we using it? No. So I'm sure most of you would be aware of what needs to be done, of what is it that is preventing you from becoming successful. What is the break in your system? What needs to be changed? I'm sure most of you would be aware. My attempt today will be to open some doors. I cannot show you the total direction in 45 minutes, but my attempt will be to act as a catalyst to open some door through which you can walk. And I want everyone to do one exercise for me. Today, tomorrow, after my lecture, ask yourself, what did you realize about yourself? Be receptive to that, whatever you are realizing, as to what is the lacuna in you. Identify that and take a small first step in that direction. And message me that you have taken that small first step in that direction. I will feel that this effort of standing here and delivering a lecture for 45 minutes will be worth it. Okay? So, I'll give you my cards later on. You can connect with me on Facebook, WhatsApp, talk to me on phone. But ask yourself in this 45 minutes, what is it that I am lacking? And take one small step, not a big step, small step in that direction. A 1,000-mile journey begins with a small step, right? So that one small step is important. Many a times we know what needs to be done. What needs to be done for becoming a good trader, for becoming successful in the market. But we don't do it. Why? First of all, these three factors are there. First is awareness. I need to be aware of my deficiencies. If I am not aware, I cannot change it. Right? An alcoholic. Okay. So awareness is one. Acceptance is second. I am aware. I am aware that I am drinking daily. But I don't accept that that is wrong. I don't accept that that is preventing me from progress in my life. So acceptance is not there. And third is action. So you may be aware of a lot of things. Today you can take a step of accepting. What comes in the way of acceptance is ego. The biggest thing which comes in the, which is a, the biggest factor is, mere ko sab kuch aata hai. I have I see the people who say all such things, I see them with tremendous respect. Because I always feel mereko kuch nahi aata hai. And every time I have to give a lecture, I have self-doubts and I need to prepare. Okay. So, accepting your deficiencies, as long as you don't accept, you won't grow in that direction. Acceptance and then action. Many a times we don't take action because that action seems too big. So we will postpone. So when you look at things together, it seems big. But when you look at it one bite at a time, it seems small. When we eat dinner, we go for the first round, second round, third round, we may eat this much. But if all that is filled in a plate and given to us to begin with, we will not be able to. So we are able to eat a lot. Why? Because one bite is small. So same way, if you have to change something, do something new, and whatever needs to be done appears to be big, break it down into actionable steps, take a small step. What's the journey of a trader? The amateur trader is like this, jumping from the plane. He is focused on what? Not the consequences. He is focused on the thrill. He's the amateur trader. Parachute, niche jaake lagega, nothing in mind. He's just enjoying. So he has no vice or amateur trader. He's no control on his emotions, no knowledge, no wisdom. That's how most of the people get into the stock market. Only two things needed. Kise mein paisa chahiye, broker chahiye. Abhi to kise mein paisa bhi nahi chahiye. Okay, that was the novice. I'll call this amateur. Amateur in the sense, thoda sa pad liya. You know, most of the traders don't realize that to be good at something, you need to put in efforts. Apna sabka problem ek hai. Padhai karna nahi hai, marks chahiye. Kaam karna nahi hai, paisa chahiye. It's a weird mentality. That's our mentality. And we need to change that. It's not what happens in life. In life, if you want to get something, you have to give something. And many a times, you have to give lots. So a trader does not understand. He is just wanting to know. Sir, mereko bolo na, ye red line, blue line, kaise interpret karne ka? He just wants some system, some technique. He doesn't understand that to make money is an activity in stock market, and for that, so many things are needed. Knowledge is just one. So this guy, no control on his emotions, just little knowledge, no wisdom. So little knowledge, kisi ne system sikha diya, moving average hai, shorter term average, crossover hota hai, le lo. That's all. They don't understand what is the average. They don't understand anything about it. One more phase I've seen is overconfident trader. They have no control over emotions, but they have too much knowledge. You know, they have a feeling, mereko sab kuch aata hai. Kon mereko kuch sikha nahi sakta. Because they have that experience of being in the market. It's like this. Too much knowledge. Essence is important of any knowledge. Why? Because we are in the market for making money, not for having knowledge. Right? So the essence is important. So a trader has to be, to make money, he has to have knowledge, but that is not enough. Since yesterday I have been listening, different speakers speaking, giving you knowledge. That's not enough. Why? Because it can't be used unless you change yourself, unless you identify what are the blocks in you. So knowledge is important, yes. Application is more important. Okay? So if you are to be good in trading, your emotions need to be in control, you need wisdom and you need knowledge. There are three people in us. One is a thrill seeker. You are doing trading, you are enjoying. Just the sheer thrill. Mera share upar ja raha hai. Yani, whatever. There's a lazy person in us and there is a serious person in us. Most of the people, like WWE mein hota hai na, there are multiple, my son teaches me, and this is a WWE stage, multiple wrestlers come in, wo do teen milke ek ko bahar fekte hai. So most of the times, in the tussle between the three, the thrill seeker and lazy person throws away the serious person. So who's in power? The thrill seeker. What we need to do? We need to weaken the thrill seeker. We need to weaken the lazy person. Then only the serious trader can grow. So many people are in the market for thrill. I always say, market, you should be emotionally neutral. Why? Thrill you can, there are other places to get thrill. Market should not be the place to get thrill. Laziness is our, what do you say, genetic, it's in our genes. So it's our attitude. As I said, kuch karna nahi hai, mere ko result chahiye. What is required for successful trading? First, knowledge which we are gathering all the time, but more importantly, a right mindset. What about knowledge? Now, many a times, Hemant and I, we used to conduct workshops for different corporates, and whenever I was asking, I was surprised that many of the analysts, by the way, I'm not talking of this group, but many of the analysts there, when we asked a question, which books you have read, there was a question mark, they didn't know the books. Someone had just taught them, ye RSI hota hai, ye overbought hota hai, ye oversold hota hai. That's all they have learnt over the job. They have not read anything, they don't know anything. So acquiring knowledge is important, but there's a pitfall in acquiring knowledge. No knowledge is the first pitfall. All of you are not in that category, of course. Too much knowledge is another pitfall. Some people, the wiring in their brain is complicated. They have too much knowledge. It happens in our field also. Like I remember, someone I knew, that lady had some pain here. And she went to a cardiologist and he checked up everything, did all the tests and he said, heart mein kuch problem nahi hai. Ar lekin pain to hai. And he had missed the simple diagnosis. It was a textbook case. She was suffering from stomach ulcer. Why? Too much knowledge. So much knowledge that you can't see the simple thing, whatever. So you should guard against too much knowledge. Any knowledge you are picking up, you should pick up the essence and what is important for you. It's okay if someone says, I don't need to attend, I don't need to learn, I have some system. Fine. Improper knowledge also. Sometimes we may read somewhere something, written word is always carries weight. Written by whom? We don't know. Is it logical? We don't know. So anything on the net, if we read, we can't believe everything. The results we get depend, now this is an important thing, not only for trading, but for your life. the results that you are getting in your life are because of what you are doing, because of your actions. So if you are rich, if you are poor, if you are successful, if you are unsuccessful, if you are happy, you are unhappy, whatever the state you are in depends on what you are doing. You are totally responsible for the state that you are in right now. And you are also responsible for the recovery. Okay. So the results will depend on what we do, but what we do will depend on what is happening inside. So like it's a chain. What I think and what I feel is going to give me the action, and that will give me the result. So it's extremely important. The question you have to ask is, what goes on in your mind every day? Is it good, bad, ugly, whatever? Because that will have its own consequences. So when I say mindset, what goes on in the mind? Two things: thoughts, emotions. When it comes to thoughts, we call something like cognitive errors or cognitive biases. The big word cognitive means related to thinking. So what are the general errors which are there in our mind? We are programmed like that to begin with. The first is the loss aversion. We are scared of pulling the trigger. Why? Because pain, suppose I lose 1 lakh of rupees and I gain 1 lakh of rupees, the pleasure and pain is not the same. The amount is the same. I'm losing 1 lakh, I'm gaining 1 lakh. But when I lose 1 lakh, that pain is bigger. When I gain 1 lakh, that pleasure is smaller. I always say there are only two things which come between you and your profits. The first is fear. You have already conquered that, because those who got put off by fear, they are out of the stock market. Now the second thing which will keep you away from profits is losses. The stock market, you try to enter the stock market and the stock market will try to kick you out. And it can kick you out of the boundary also. So you have to worry about losses. Now you don't have to worry about fear. You have overcome, you have come into the market. But the second enemy sitting there is losses. The financial injury, stock market is like a fighting going on. And what can happen? You can get financially injured or you can suffer from financial death. Now, is financial death acceptable? No. Injury acceptable? Yes, but there is a limit to it. You need to identify. Every trader needs to identify how much injury he can bear, how much injury he can take and still continue. Inability to do so results in more financial injury and you get kicked out of the market. So extremely important, today I am not going into it, the risk to reward ratio, the position size, extremely important, because that is going to put you into risk and losses. Overconfidence. So always better to be little scared. Like I was mentioning that point, like too many people are obsessed, traders especially, not the speakers, I won't say, because speakers, that's their job, that's an intellectual exercise for them. But too many traders are obsessed about figuring out the top and bottom. I always say the best thing is pick up the middle, safe profit. Wave one, you cannot get into. Evening we'll be talking about Elliott wave theory. Wave 5 is risky. Wave 3, your attempt should be to get into wave 3, capitalize, safe middle zone. You don't need to be obsessed about picking up at the very bottom and selling at the very top. That doesn't make you a good trader. I will define a good trader as a trader who minimizes his risk. He may not take profits from bottom to top in a stock, but he will take a safe profit. When I learned technical analysis, my family members also learned technical analysis, and my younger son used to sometimes sit with me while we were trading, and many a times I would sell off and then the share would go up, and he would get emotionally hassled ki apne ko aur profit mil sakta tha, which always a trader feels. So I always used to tell him one line, a dialogue, which I'll tell you also. Life mein jo sab kuch dikhta hai wo apna nahi hota, jo milta hai wohi apna hota hai. You know? So you should not worry about, dikhta to bahut hai, market mein dikhte to rahega. You should focus on minimizing your risk. And that you should do consciously. Let go of extra profits, no problem. Safe profits are you able to pick up? Wave 3, safe profits are you able to pick up? That is the question. So overconfidence is another problem with many of the people. And real life mein mera height itna hi rehta hai. Kam bhi nahi hota hai, jyada bhi nahi hota hai. Stock market alag environment hai. When I win, mera height badh jata hai. When I lose, mera height kam ho jata hai. So when I win, I become euphoric. My self-control is gone. If I was trading 5 lots, I'll go to 50 lots or 20 lots, and then I am in for trouble. So that control has to be there. Another is confirmation bias. The economist Keynes used to say, when my information changes, I alter my conclusions. That's the logical thing. You have to look for information, and when it changes, alter it. But what do? We always try to see and hear what we want to. When we are in a position, if you have traded, you will have this experience. When you are in position and it is going against you, it's difficult to accept that you have gone wrong. You will try to find something positive. You will try to fit something. Bandwagon effect, being with the crowd, it always feels safe. But understand one thing, contrarian doesn't mean always be against the crowd. You will get crushed. You can't go against the crowd during the trend. At the tops, at the turning points, you should be not with the crowd. So you should understand when you should be with the crowd and when you should stay away from them. What is the quality of a master? I like playing chess, so I'll give you an example from that. Grandmasters of chess, they know when to break rules. That's the difference. They know the rules, but they know the exceptions also. Right? So you should know when to be with the crowd and when not to be with the crowd. We have tremendous resistance to change. A simple thing, you go to most of us, I'm saying, when we go to a restaurant, we will have some set of restaurants. We'll not try out new ones. We'll have a certain set of our menu. We'll not try out. That's for the majority. So we need to be open, flexible, looking for opportunities to learn, to change. Negativity bias means if something positive happens, we let go immediately. But if something negative happens, it has a bigger impact. 3 times you will win a lakh of rupees, And one time if you lose a lakh of rupees, that impact will be there. Like I remember a friend of mine, a doctor, he gave an injection to someone and that person went into shock, suddenly collapsed. Now the incidence of reaction following vaccination is 1 in 1,000,000. But unfortunately it happened. Second time he scared to give. Why? Because of the negative experience. But the probability is 1 in 1,000,000. So it is hardly likely that the second case also will be like that. So we have to guard against negativity coming into our way. I'll go a little fast. Okay. What about emotions? We have, now this is important to understand. We have a normal mood. Everyone's normal mood is at different level. I may be more cheerful normally than you, or I may be less cheerful normally than you. What happens when I become happy? Something good happens when I become happy. And when I become happy, my self-control is gone. I become impulsive. You must have experienced it. When you go to a mall, you're feeling good. You tend to spend more. You will not bargain. You lose that self-control. On the road, if you go shopping, already the heat is there and you are not happy, and there you will bargain. But little happiness, and the takeaway from this is what? That when you are trading and if you win, you will become happy. And when you become happy, the next trade, your mindset is not going to be the ideal one. So you need to be able to control. How should you approach the market? Not happy, not sad. Neutral, cold, logical. Okay. If something bad happens, you will go into a little depression, so fear, and you will tend to avoid the market. Well, that's fine for some time. But you need to be, your mood needs to be normal. So that is one extremely important takeaway from here. If you are happy, don't trade. If you are sad, don't trade. Trade only if you can stay away, be cool. Then only that's the time to trade. See the effect, like different people, or the way society looks at things. If I go and put bet money on horses, it is considered bad. Bolenge jua is gambling. If I go and play cards, people will look down on me. But if I open Economic Times, people will say, learned man. Economic Times is different color. So many people reading Economic Times are actually masked gamblers. Every trader needs to have one check with himself. Is he a gambler? Because if he is a gambler, he is going to lose. That is his personality trait, and he cannot win. So if you are a gambler, you should stay away. Okay, so basically you get addicted. The problem with gambling, a gambler is what? His mindset is, he cannot stop. If I go and shop, I will shop only till the balance, some positive I will maintain. If my wife goes and shops, she'll make it to zero. If a gambler goes, he cannot stop till he creates a negative. So, you know, many people go on playing cards and they are winning, but they can't get up. They will get up only when they lose a certain amount. So that's their set point. So if you are a gambler, a trader who's a gambler is going to He wins, 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 but he cannot stop. And he's going to be euphoric and make some mistakes, and then he's going to lose, 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 and go into problems. So I'll go fast through it. Okay. Now, before a trade, the big mistake. Now, let's come to what can be done. No analysis. That's because of our laziness or ignorance or lack of knowledge, lack of ability. Incomplete analysis, again due to laziness. Many people, when I ask them, my students, kya dikhta hai chart mein? So immediately they'll say, head and shoulder dikhta hai, ye dikhta hai. So they'll see only one thing. Analysis is complete analysis. A patient comes to me, he says, fever hai. So immediately I give crocin. Complete analysis. Fever hai, aur kya hai, kis karan hai, all other things. So a complete analysis is needed, which is at times missing. Over analysis. Sometimes people, they analyze so much that they don't pull the gun. During a trade, what is the problem? No monitoring. A trader should be very cautious and alert after that, when his trade is on. No monitoring is one, or over-monitoring. I teach my students simple thing, entry and exit. For entry, you have to be a technical analyst and a good technical analyst. For entry, you have to analyze completely. You may take 10 hours to analyze, hours to analyze. You can look at charts, ulta, seedha, niche se, upar se, all that. For exit, now this is a takeaway for you. For exit, being a technical analyst is a handicap. For exit, it should be only one simple rule. And what is that rule? When will you exit? When your stop loss is triggered. That should be the rule. Many a times, so for entries, you should be a technical analyst. But when it comes to exit, you should forget all technical analysis. Exits always should be, keep a trailing stop loss by some system, and you forget, stop analyzing. Just let it trail, and if the stop loss is hit. So many a times I keep asking my students, ulta sulta, beech beech mein, and they fall into the trap. I show a chart and I ask them, when will you exit? And they'll say, sir, when I see head and shoulders, sir, when I see wave 5 getting over. I say, all that is not what we are looking for. The only thing you should have in mind for exit is when your stop loss is triggered. Upar kuch bhi karne do. If I keep a stop loss of 7-day average, uske upar head and shoulders batao, negative kuch bhi pata, negative divergence hai, don't look at it. Stop loss. That's the only thing. Okay. After a trade, now this is extremely important. No one does a post-mortem. The good doctors are those who treat a patient, but when the treatment fails or for some reason the patient dies, they go and attend the post-mortem and they check out what went wrong. But every trader needs to keep a log and needs to write notes on what basis he entered, what basis he exited, and he should do a post-mortem later on. That post-mortem will give a pattern of your problems, you know, pattern of your psychology. Brooding too much on what has happened. Excessive, some people excessively keep thinking. Okay. So to open your eyes, you need to close your eye. Means the ego part. I won't go through this because the time is short. Okay. How do you develop wisdom? Basically, learning from others' mistakes. You should be open. I always say, if you are receptive, every event happening in your life, every person walking into your life, every person you interact with, it should be a learning experience. Because everything will teach you how to or how not to. Okay? So it should be a learning experience. Best is learn from others' experience. The second best is learn from your own experience. But that is costly. The third is not learn at all, which is very costly. Okay. Basically, to be in control of your emotions, the emotions are going to go up and down. Everyone is a different person. So you have to figure out what kind of emotions are coming in the way. Now, obstacles are put in your way to see if what you want is really worth fighting for. So people always don't like obstacles. Yeah, we want shortcuts, simple things. But if everything was so simple, then life would have been different. What to do about obstacles? I'll give you. Okay, by the way, I'm going to distribute. This is my book, Magic and Logic of Eliot Waves. It's currently out of print. Our publisher has not printed right now, but he'll do it. And there are four copies. We'll be distributing all four today, two right now, and two after the Eliot discussion. One will be to the best answer, and one will be to the best question. Okay. So afterwards, whatever questions you are asking, the question which I feel is best will get that copy. And the best answer, now I'm asking you a question. You are walking on a road. Both sides of the road are blocked. And you want to go ahead. In between, there is a huge stone you see. You want to go ahead. How will you go? Shoot your answers. Climb. Climbing is not possible. The stone is too steep. Bend is not possible. Like, there's no way that stone has covered.
Move the stone.
Turning away is not what
roll,
we
roll
want.
The stone ahead and move.
Reverse, not possible.
Break the stone.
Break the stone. With what? You don't have anything. It's too huge. What is?
Dig the road.
No, digging also is not possible. You don't have anything. It is fixed. You can't roll. It's too huge. Look for alternative. You don't want.
Side mein ho jao. Sir, side mein ho jao.
Go back.
Sir, side mein ho jao.
It's a difficult question, I know. But
sir?
Okay. Okay. Stop there. No. No. When I was asked this question, it's difficult to get. Even I did not get it. It's difficult to get because it is a different question. I said, I will climb. He said, climbing not possible. I said, I'll dig a hole. He said, digging a hole not possible. I said, I'll make a hole, making a hole not possible. I said, I'll get a helicopter and go. He says, there is no helicopter.
Find something else to do. Pursue something else.
No. Okay. Then I said, I'll take a pole and do pole vaulting. He says, there is no pole. I think I like that answer. Imagine you are already out. Something different out of the box. Yeah. Who's he? What's your name? Yeah. Answer is difficult to get because it's different. It is make yourself so big that the stone becomes small. Now there is something to learn from this, that whenever we are faced with a situation in life, we are totally focused on this problem. See, when I asked you, or when even I was asked this, my focus was totally on the stone. Stone ko kuch to karenge. Todo. Focus is not here. Focus is on the stone. Problem udhar hai. Problem udhar hai, lekin you can't do anything. Whenever problem is there, you can't do anything. There are only two ways to solve any problem. Change the situation or change yourself. You can't change the situation here. Then you need to change yourself. That's why I like this answer. That was related to changing oneself. Like, you know. So make yourself so big that the stone becomes small. So do, that's it. Okay. Sometimes when there are obstacles and you can't go through it, you can't go over it, you have to go through it. Nothing can be done. Okay. I'll give 5 minutes for some questions. I have lots to talk, but there's a time constraint. Yeah.
Very desirable outcome. So when masters know when to bend the rules, can you give me some example? Thank you.
I don't consider myself a master. First, let us become masters. So let us not break rules. No, really, I am saying, let us focus only on following the rules. The simplest rule, which is told by all the teachers till now in the last 100 years, taught by all trainers, is trade with the trend. Do we follow it?
No.
So let us follow whatever rules are there. They are enough to make money. Question? Yeah.
Yeah, hello sir, my name is Ankit.
Yeah.
Sir, I just want to ask you one question, that is it advisable to be a full-time trader, or is it advisable to be in a particular full-time job? Like in your case, you're a doctor. So myself, I'm a chartered accountant doing a service and also trading. So is it advisable to take a full-time career psychologically or?
Second,
what percentage of allocation of savings or capital, which is other than routine spending, should be done when a person is under 30, under 40, under 50?
Okay, the second question I will advise for, answer first. Generally, it is said that 100 minus age should be the maximum you put into risky assets. So if you're, what is your age?
27.
So 30. So 100 minus age, so you can put up to 70% in risky assets. But 30% should be in non-risky assets. Now that's the general rule. You can shift a bit. Okay. Second, let me answer, that is an interesting question. I always feel the best way to earn money is first through non-risky methods. I practice, no risk. I give lectures, train, no risk. Okay. You may be having a job, so no risk. So no risky income, without risk income is the best. Right? It's like this, that you want to go from Andheri to Church Gate. You can sit inside, then why you want to latak ke kyu jana hai? So I feel no risk income, if you are getting, that should be your first priority. And if you are satisfied with it, then maybe you can invest or do part-time trading just for because you like it or you want to do it. But you should not think of getting into full-time trading. First, build something up. Then maybe after a certain level of wealth is built up, you can decide whether you want to get into full-time. So I won't advise you to get into full-time trading because the success rate is less and you have an equally good option of earning money without risk. So explore that, build something, side by side take this trading experience, and that is this.
Sir, yeah.
Yeah.
Excuse me?
Yeah.
I'm already in the queue.
Yeah, yeah, please.
Yes, sir. So you said that you have to outgrow yourself in order to become larger than the stone.
Yeah.
What if the stone is large enough and you are my miniature in the structure comparatively as of now? Where do you get the nourishment in order to get to cross the road? Like you gave an example, you are traveling from Andheri to Church Gate.
Yeah.
You can have a safe seat inside the compartment.
Yeah.
What's the need to hang out?
Yeah.
At 8 o'clock, there's no train starting from Andheri to Church Gate.
Yeah.
You have to board a train coming from Borivali,
yeah,
which is already loaded.
Yeah.
So I do not have a choice.
Yeah.
So what to do in that situation?
So when
do I have to wait till 10 o'clock for the train to arrive and start from Andheri?
The first thing is, when you don't have a choice, I don't see any conflict. Or I don't see any confusion. You don't have a choice, you don't have a choice. Phir latak ke jana hai, right? Whether abhi latak ke jau ya 10 baje andar khade rehke jau, that depends on the risk assessment. Abhi latkega to jyada se jyada kya injury ho sakega. Bahut injury agar hoga, to it's better to go by the next train.
But the question is, both the sides were blocked.
Yeah.
And the stone was blocking your way.
Yes.
Now you are not outgrowing the stone.
Yeah.
And you are not getting enough nourishment in time to, yeah, outgrow it.
Yeah. What I will say is, the example I gave, I am not saying that every stone which you encounter, you will be able to be bigger than it. So, obviously in life, you will come across some stones where the stones are too huge, and you won't be able to outgrow it. So in that case, you have to go back or you have to let go. But in cases where you can become bigger, your focus should be on becoming bigger. But then, in a nutshell, what I am saying is, focus should not be on the stone. Your focus should be on developing yourself, building yourself up. And if you become bigger than the stone, fine. If not, turn away.
Sir, hi, my name is Manisha, yeah, and...
She is talking, just a minute. Let me... Yeah, after.
How do you increase your
emotional intelligence word is used quite often and at times not properly. I feel so. Everyone does not need to increase the emotional intelligence. You have to understand the deficiencies in you. If you are emotionally more sensitive, then you need to become emotionally less intelligent. So you have to figure out what is needed. Should you increase your sensitiveness or should you decrease it? For example, jokingly in lectures I say that my wife is so emotionally intelligent that at times she detects all the emotions which I even don't have in me. So sometimes she is highly perceptive. So I want to say that some people need to increase their sensitivity, but at the same time some people will need to decrease their emotional intelligence. So there is some optimum. So you have to figure out where you are. Are you in control of your emotions or not? And if you are not, take steps accordingly. Yeah. Yes.
So, how far is trading in the stock market is related to that disorder? And are there any research to show that there are particular specific sectors in the brain which can either reward or punish the trader?
Yeah. See, there is a disorder called obsessive compulsive disorder. In which a patient's obsession means repeated thoughts and compulsions mean repeated acts. So suppose I go and wash my hands all the time, it is a compulsion. Part of my mind tells me to do that. I can't resist it. And obsession is some thought comes again and again, like touch this mic, whatever. I'm doing it again and again, that's a obsession. This is a compulsion, but some before that, that thought coming is an obsession. Now, I didn't take that, but that is also one of the disorder which some people have in trading. They can be obsessive. They don't have the disorder, but they have that kind of personality. So they will put orders at specific numbers only, you know. So they'll put orders at specific numbers. They will believe too much in luck. They will get into specific scripts only. So they are quite obsessed about certain things.
Can I ask? Dr. Joshi,
yeah.
If you agree with a belief of mine, then please answer this question. Yeah. I believe the most powerful enemy I would ever meet is within me.
Yeah.
If you agree with that, then please tell me, what is the most important thing to do to take care of this enemy within?
Yes. The most important book to Mr. Kedia. I think.
I would surely receive it after you give the answer, but I'll receive it on behalf of the Atma Library, which we have at the BSC building.
Yeah.
It would be good to have your rare book for all of us.
Yeah. Very apt question, and which probably I'd forgotten to answer. The enemy is not outside. Always we are focused on the outside. The enemy is inside. And how you can overcome that enemy is, as I said, those steps. The first is becoming aware. And why will you become aware? If you are constantly introspecting, human beings only have the habit of introspection. Animals don't introspect. Maine kya kiya, kaise kiya. Animals don't think on that. But human beings do introspect. So the habit of introspection has to be developed. With that, what will happen? You will become aware of things. So your sensitivity to your deficiencies or what is happening to the workings of your mind, what thoughts are coming, what are the different parts of my mind, which part is saying what, that awareness has to be increased. And after that, acceptance. And then working on it, taking some action. So it's a process, it won't immediately give results, but the process, first step is introspection, developing the habit of introspection, which will lead to more awareness about your own thoughts and feelings, and that will lead to then acceptance, and from that, some actions to control that. Yeah. You are aware, suppose you are a smoker, you are aware, you have accepted. Now the question is action. One trick I can tell you is control your environment. If I am a smoker and I have cigarettes here, I am going to be tempted to light. There are no cigarettes here. I stay in a place which is away from cigarettes. Alcoholics for rehabilitation are kept in an enclosed environment where no alcohol is there. So, changing the environment, extremely important. I shifted to a new house. In my old house, I used to walk in through the door and the light switch was on the right side. And in my new house, I walk through the door and light switch is here. So my habit is I walk right hand and there is no switch. I do it for 4-5 days, there's no switch. Now I developed the habit. So habits take repeatedly if you do something. But suppose there was one switch here also and there also, then I would not have changed. Then my habit would have continued. So change your environment. I stay at Vidyavihar. Sometimes I go by train. When I walk on the bridge, there are entries on both sides. My first class compartment is left side. Now they have closed that. So there's a bridge. So many a times I'm walking in my thought and I turn and then I realize there is a bund there. Then I have to take the other way. So repeatedly, if you do the new action, the change won't happen immediately. So repeatedly, when you keep doing the action, then that change will be happening slowly. And second thing, when it comes to trading, is a process. You have to have a process for finding stocks, for screening, for evaluating stocks, process for entry, when you are going to enter, process on how you are going to monitor, process on when you are going to exit, process about the postmortem that you are going to do, and the introspection you are going to do. So it should be some process which you need to develop. That's it? Yeah, last one. There's always the possibility that when your power increases, the other part of your mind will take over. But if you have that attitude of a student, because you realize that however big you may grow, there's still something left. Ego comes when you feel you have already grown big enough. Okay? So keep in mind, there is always a further level up. Thank you. Yeah, algo trading, whatever system you have in mind, if you are able to put it into the computer, and what is algo trading? What I have in my mind, the ideas and the actions that I do of buy and sell, I am outsourcing to a computer program, because that computer program will not have any emotional blocks. So that is good. So the exact ideas, if you put into the computer, but you have to backtest and see. So I'm positive about it. Yeah.